Hello friends, are you ready for a quick challenge on rational numbers? Can you group the following rational numbers according to their decimal expansions? One of the ways to do it is to check the prime factors of the denominator of each of these numbers. If the prime factors are other than 2 or 5, the decimal form is non-terminating recurring. Otherwise, it is terminating. That is a good learning. But then there remains a question. Is it possible that the decimal form is non-terminating, but digits after decimal point are not repeating? An example is to have a number like 1.20342709. Then what do we call such a number? Let us explore the name given to these numbers. Look at this triangle. This is a right angle triangle with perpendicular sides equal to 3 and 4 units. How do we find its diagonal? We use Pythagoras' theorem, so the diagonal is equal to 5. Now let us take the next triangle. This is 45 by 45 by 90 degrees set square. What is special about this right angle triangle? It has two equal sides, so it is an isosceles right angle triangle. Let's say the two equal sides are of length 1 unit each. Then by using Pythagoras' theorem, the diagonal is equal to square root of 2. Let us find out the value of square root of 2 so that we will be able to represent it on the number line. We know that 49 can be written as 7 multiplied by 7. So 49 is the square of 7, or 7 is the square root of 49. So to find the square root of 2, we have to find that number which when multiplied by itself will give 2 as the product. We know that 2 is not perfect square number. Also, 2 lies between perfect square numbers 1 and 4. Square root of 1 is 1. Square root of 4 is 2. That means 1 is less than square root of 2 is less than 2. Now, let us take the decimal square number more than 1 and less than 2. It is 1.96 whose square root is 1.4. Square of 1.4 will be 1.96, but this is less than 2. Let us take a slightly higher number, 1.5. Then, square of 1.5 will be 2.25, but this is greater than 2. So, the square root of 2 must be greater than 1.4. So, the square root of 2 must be greater than 1.4, but less than 1.5. So, greater than 1.4 means, let's take 1.41. Now, 1.41 multiplied by 1.41 is equal to 1.9881, which is still less than 2. So, now let's take number as 1.42. Now, 1.42 multiplied by 1.42 is equal to 2.0164, which is greater than 2. So, the number must be greater than 1.41 but less than 1.42. So, greater than 1.41 means, let's take 1.411. 1.411 multiplied by 1.411 is equal to 1.990921, which is still less than 2. So, let's take 1.412. 1.412 multiplied by 1.412 is equal to 1.993744, which is still less than 2. So, now let's take 1.413. 1.413 multiplied by 1.413 is equal to 1.996569. which is still less than 2. So, now let's take 1.414. 1.414 multiplied by 1.414 is equal to 1.999396, still less than 2. So let us take 1.415. 1.415 multiplied by 1.415 is equal to 2.002225, which is now more than 2. That means the number must be greater than 1.414 but less than 1.415. So let us take 1.4141. 1.4141 multiplied by 1.4141 is equal to 1.999678881, still less than 2. So now let's take 1.4142. 1.4142 multiplied by 1.4142 is equal to 1.99996164, still less than 2. So let us take 1.4143. 1.4143 multiplied by 1.4143 is equal to 2.00024449, now more than 2. That means the number must be greater than 1.4142 but less than 1.4143. So now let's take 1.41421. 1.41421 multiplied by 1.41421 is equal to 1.99998992411, still less than 2. So let's take 1.41422. 1.41422 multiplied by 1.41422 is equal to 2.00001820084. Now it is more than 2. What does it mean? That means the number is more than 1.41421 but less than 1.41422. And if we do this n number of times, we get square root of 2 is equal to 1.41421356. Note that numbers after decimal point are unending, which means decimal form is non-terminating. Also, there is no recurring pattern of digits after decimal point. So, we cannot write such numbers as ratio of two integers p upon q, where q is not equal to 0. What can you conclude about this now? You would have noticed we are facing difficulty in estimating square root of 2 accurately, though we have sufficient tools of calculations available with us. Interestingly, such number does exist definitely. So, we can show it on number line and its location is after 1.4. Let us see how to represent this on number line. So, though we can show on the number line, but we are not able to measure it accurately in spite of having enough tools to measure. Such numbers are not measurable or we cannot estimate them. These numbers are not rational numbers and hence are called as irrational numbers. Let us take another example of an irrational number. Try dividing the circumference of a circle by its diameter. The answer reads something like 3.1415926535897932384, and it goes on and on forever. The calculation never terminates nor shows any repeating pattern of any sort. This is the number pi, which is an irrational number. But when we find area or circumference of the circle, we take its value as 22 upon 7 or sometimes 3.14. The ratio 22 upon 7 or 3.14 is just an approximation which we use for the purpose of calculation. Otherwise, it will not be possible to calculate the values. So, numbers like square root of 2 or pi are irrational numbers which have many applications in the real world. That means, area or volume of the shapes that involve a circle, such as cylinder, sphere, hemisphere, cone, etc., basically are irrational numbers as they involve the irrational number pi. So, we calculate these by approximating pi as 22 upon 7 or 3.14. Numbers that cannot be represented as ratio of two integers p and q, such that q is not equal to 0 and where their decimal expansion does not terminate nor show any repeating pattern, are called irrational numbers. Both rational and irrational numbers form real numbers denoted by symbol R.